Welcome into a brand new episode of WSI TV. Enjoy the show.
Welcome back for a brand new episode of WSI TV. I'm Sean Bauer. With me, as always, is Jordan Bishop. And we are just coming off an incredible annual Wealth Summit weekend where we just had a lot of fun with you guys who were in attendance this past Saturday and Sunday. And we were actually able to record the first ever live episode of WSI TV.
That's exactly right. And surprisingly, it went off without a hitch. You know, right. We actually got things right. There was no bloopers to show you, unfortunately. But yeah. We did record that live episode. We are going to get that into your email inbox. But I just want to say, if you came out and you met us and you spoke to us and you witnessed that first live episode, thank you so much. We really appreciate that. We appreciate all the feedback you gave us. And now we're back here in the studio, hopefully bringing you some more exciting content. So let's go through what we got for them today, Sean.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to get into a little fun here with the game first, but we will be getting to what is going to be the topic of the day, where we're talking about a $7 million tip from a Schwab insider. We're going to show you what that could mean for you and your money in just a minute. And then we're going to brag a little bit at the end, and a congratulations if you were in attendance at that annual Wealth Summit. You just made some money this week, as we'll get to in a few minutes. But first, let's start with one of our favorite games here. If your answer isn't Trusky, drink that brewski.
Yeah, so basically, we've got some stock tickers here that we're gonna go head to head with. I'm gonna say a stock ticker, Sean has to guess the company. If he gets it wrong, I get a point, and then, you know, vice versa. So these have been handpicked by our video producer, and, you know, so we don't know what's coming to us.
We haven't seen them yet. Yeah.
So it might be interesting. The loser of this round has to chug this brewski right here. Nice Modelo there, but you know, I don't know if you feel like chugging it, Sean, but I'm probably gonna stick to the whiskey after I win this one.
Yeah, you always do anyway. All right, well, Jordan, since you're so confident, you are going first, and the ticker is XEL.
That is, it's gotta be an energy company.
Yes.
I'm drawing blanks here.
It is Xcel Energy. Thank goodness, zero points to start.
I'll take notes on that one. For you, I have OFG.
I have absolutely no idea. So
it's,
pass.
It's not a good round this time. Oriental Financial Group.
Okay, 0 points to start. But we're gonna improve from here. Your ticker is DAL.
DAL, it's Delta.
It's Delta Airlines, that
has
is correct.
Has to be Delta.
All right, 1 point to Jordan.
Sean, for you, I have TGT.
Target, right?
Yeah,
nice. Finally, looking a whole lot better now.
Absolutely.
Okay, your third of four, this ticker is MDGL.
MDGL is...
tough one.
I have no idea.
Madrigal Pharma Inc.
Okay.
I had to give you a curveball there, so
you
no
did,
points.
Yeah, yeah. All right, well, back at you, Sean. CZR.
Little Caesars?
No, Caesars Entertainment Corp.
All right, close. Had a word in there. Okay, your last ticker is HOG.
HOG is Harley Davidson.
Yes, it is. 2 points.
All right, Sean, I'm going to give you this one anyway. SCHW.
SCHW is Schwab, right?
Yeah, so what are we tied to?
Yeah, producer, just give us a ticker. First one to guess it wins.
Yeah, just
anything. You can make it obvious as well. We'll prepare in the meantime with a nice little glass of whiskey. So I just had our producer run over and get us a tiebreaker stock. Do you have that one for us? All right, here we go. We're just gonna do sudden death here. We only have one. So what am I? I'm giving you the ticker, right?
Yep.
The ticker is BAC.
BAC is Bank of America.
I'm gonna have words.
Chug that brewski.
I'm gonna have words with our producer for giving you that easy of a tiebreaker.
I'm pretty sure I was talking about Bank of America at some point today too. So
yeah.
At least we know he's listening, right?
Fair enough.
All right. So as
Take
Sean,
yep,
as
me.
Sean chugs that brewski, as you've seen him do many times before. I'm not calling him a loser, but you know. we're gonna move on to how this Schwab insider is gonna show you how to take a nice payout. You didn't chug that
it's
whole
too
thing.
Cold.
I'm sorry. Let's warm it up a little bit. So basically, a Schwab insider today sold 156 1,100 shares. You know, so what's all that about? I'm sure you've seen it. It's been making big headlines lately. How do we turn that into money in your pocket? And Sean, once you've digested that beer, you feel good to jump back in and take this back over?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, what we're going to be alluding to here in a second is all the noise you're seeing, especially in these sorts of headlines. But this is kind of a trending topic we just saw this week. And obviously, I mean, we are talking about big money here when it's almost $8 million. It is a bit of a tip, you know, a little hint left by these insiders here. And this is just one insider selling all of these shares, all of that money in the bank. And obviously, we have there the share price for you. You can also see on the chart, this has actually been up a big amount in the last few months, as we'll get to in a second.
Right, exactly. And as Sean told us in that round, we went head to head. SCHW is Schwab's ticker. So you can take a look at that, at the price, at how it's doing. Because of course, we want to look at the charts. This headline's great and everything. But what are your first thoughts when you see this headline? What do you think? I mean, Sean, when we first started trading, let's just take you back there.
Sure.
Quite a few years ago. And that headline pops up.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts right there?
You know, I see a big insider, an insider who's supposed to have some, you know, inside knowledge of Schwab, of this company, and he's selling a ton of shares, ripping his money out of the company, basically. You know, I'm thinking he already knows something that's gonna take the stock down. He clearly sees share prices going down, and should I be following suit? I'm probably starting to panic if I have a bunch of money in Schwab right now.
Right.
What
so
about you?
So that might sound familiar to you guys.
Yeah.
I would have had those first thoughts as well when I first started trading, when I first started taking notice of the stock market. And don't worry if that's your first thought. You know, again, just take a look at that headline again.
Right.
You know, it's an insider of Schwab is selling over 150,000 shares, right? Automatically you panic. So
yeah.
It's not what you think though, right, Sean? I mean, and now that we know, you know, we've got some experience on our side, we want to transfer that to you and show you exactly how we'd play this deal.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a little bit more digging is required when you see a big headline like that. First of all, he didn't sell all of his shares in Schwab. He still owns actually a ton, 277,000. So only sold roughly a third of his position or so, to do the rough math there. You also need to look again at the chart like we were just telling you. Schwab is up 30% in the past 3 months. Financials in general have been flying really with this market. So you can see that Schwab itself seems to be in really good standing. And again, this insider isn't just ripping all of his money out. He sold and he got a nice chunk of it out, but he still has all of these shares in there.
So with all this information, right, your first thought was, oh, I gotta get out of my Schwab position, or I got a short Schwab. But with the information Sean's just provided about that insider still holding 277,000 shares, you know, these are things that you don't hear about unless you dig deeper into it.
Yeah.
Those headlines are what we like to call the noise,
mm-hmm.
right? And the noise affects your trading. It messes with your money. You know, and if you listen to that noise, you're gonna be steered in the wrong direction. And by the noise, we just mean headlines, basically. People
right.
talking like they know what they're talking about. Those headlines are there to trip you up, basically. You know, they're looking for that solid, sweet piece that they wanna drag, that they wanna use to drag readers in. And that's not how we do it around here, is it, Sean?
No, I mean, they're looking for clicks, obviously, which is fair enough. But this is, again, like Jordan said, noise. And you know a little bit about this if you were at the annual Wealth Summit. We talked about it a little bit. Noise creeps in and allows your emotions to get into your trades, which is the worst enemy of a trader or investor. We're not gonna do that. What we wanna show you now is a little bit of insight into the insiders themselves, like the Schwab insider who just sold, you know, $7 million, $8 million worth of shares. Let's look at why they might sell. So first of all, obviously, they might sell because they do think the price is going down. They might see some bad news, whatever, on the horizon where they see the share price going down, and they wanna obviously get out and protect their own money. But that's not all, right?
Right, that's not the only reason they sell. They also sell because, I mean, think about it. So this guy got $7.9 million like that, like by selling his shares that he already owned. Maybe he wanted a, you know, maybe he needed medical, you know, maybe he needed money for medical expenses. He could have been looking to put his child through college.
Yeah.
He could have been looking to buy a new house.
And maybe he just wants a yacht or something like
exactly.
that.
Exactly. So picture that. You've got $7.9 million tied up in your company's stock. You can sell it anytime you want. Not to mention you've got whatever the 270,000 shares add up to on the other side of it. So he's just sold a small chunk of those shares. He's taken, he's basically gone to the ATM and pulled out $7.9 million. Now, does that mean there's bad news on the horizon for Schwab?
Maybe. Right. Maybe not.
But yeah, I mean, probably not. You know, otherwise he would have pulled out all his shares.
True.
Because, you know, if he's this insider and clearly he's high up in the company because he has all this, that's a lot of shares, that's a lot of money. You don't just get that for being, you know, a first year trader at Schwab. but basically, just because he's pulled this money out, it doesn't mean Schwab's stock is going down, and it's instinctual to feel that way when you see a headline like that. But reading into the whole story, and more specifically looking at the charts, is the right way to do it, especially when it comes to your finances. Now, of course, there's multiple ways, there's multiple reasons of why insiders might sell, but there's only one reason why they might buy.
Every single time, an insider is only gonna buy if they think the share price is going up. And this is just using common sense, right? That's the only reason they're gonna put money into a stock, the only reason they're gonna invest. I mean, the same as us.
Right.
Jordan and I, even you at home sitting there, you're only gonna put money into a stock if you think the price is going up. That's exactly how these insiders react. Again, against all those, however many reasons there could have, the infinite reasons for selling the stock, there's only one reason to buy. They think the stock price is going up. So that's really what you wanna look for, especially like we're talking about with all this noise, where you see headlines like this all the time. X insider is selling this amount of stock. It's noise, okay? So look at the chart, like we always say, the price tells you everything in the chart. You can see trend lines, you can see moving averages. It tells you everything you need to know. And that's exactly what it did here with Schwab.
Right, so the point of this is that headline, you know, Schwab insider sells 156 plus thousand shares. It's meant to make you feel the need to you know, pull your money out of Schwab or you know, short Schwab or whatever. But you know, that's what we're getting at here is that's going to steer you in the wrong direction. And you can apply this to anything. You know, if you own shares in Apple and you hear, you know, Apple phones haven't been delivered, or if you own shares of Tesla, and then you hear, you know, Tesla can't deliver on their Model 3, but they've also come out with a semi truck. You know, it doesn't mean that you should go short sell with the Model 3 failure, and not failure, but you know
setback. Yeah,
setback, and then go buy shares with the semi truck. Because if you were following that, you'd be on the tail end of every movement.
Right.
It's already in the charts. You know.
Absolutely.
And that's exactly how you should play it. Technical analysis is the way to go, and that's what we're here for, to guide you through that.
Yeah, and if there is, I mean, perhaps this insider sees this big stock market bubble, he thinks it's about to burst, so he's starting to get out. If this $7.9 million move is a tip that where Schwab is going in the downward direction, you're gonna start to see that in the chart. You're gonna see it there. That's gonna give you the hint you need to get your money where it needs to be. And again, that's something we're teaching you all the time through all of our systems and strategies. So yeah, that's a really good insight, I think, into how these insiders react. Now let's move on to a little bit more fun. And if you were at last weekend's annual Wealth Summit, again, thank you for being there. And congratulations, because not to toot our own horn, but we did have an actual brilliant fuel cell penny stock pick from the penny stock king himself.
Right, FCEL, you know, as I taught in the system during the Sunday, if you were there, you know, it was just that perfect closing above the 40-week moving average on the weekly, and it just took off. It took off. We tracked it from the closing price on Friday. It jumped up 18.3%, and today, you know, I mean, we're recording right now.
Yeah, so it's yesterday's Thursday's close up 18.3%. So a week, and you have this sort of gain. That's just ridiculous, and that's actually, I mean, now I've become accustomed to it just from sitting across from Jordan in the office, where I'm getting these all day, every day, pretty much. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. So we hoped you at the summit. We hoped you opened up your Robinhood account. You know, it's what I use for my penny stocks. And congratulations if you took this 18.3% gain from this.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, on behalf of Jordan and myself and the rest of our team here at WSI TV, thank you very much for being in attendance at the annual Wealth Summit. And again, if you weren't, we do have that live episode that we recorded. That's gonna be coming to you very soon, hopefully within the next week or so. We'll get that out to you, so you know, be on the look for that. In the meantime, please give us a subscribe. You'll get all of this content coming regularly, a couple of times a week. And go ahead and comment any topics you'd like us to cover or anything like that. But in the meantime, it is time for us to sign off. So we will say thanks for watching, and we'll speak to you next time. Cheers.
Thanks for watching the latest episode of WSITV. Be sure to visit WSITV.com, where you can subscribe for free with no contract and gain instant access to the secrets of self-made millionaires via the WSITV Vault. So go ahead and claim this gift for free now at WSITV.com.